What's up, guys?
Hey!
Welcome back to another episode of Driving Triad. Today, we're headed up to Boone. We're going to show you what you can do with a little hour and a half road trip up the mountains. Stick around. I'm Joel.
I'm Fletcher.
We woke up this morning, figured it's still summertime here
still
in North
hot.
Carolina.
Still hot.
Still hot. It's going to be about 87 degrees. Why not get away to the mountains?
10 degrees cooler up here on a pretty regular basis.
Yep.
And we're literally driving the Triad today.
We are driving the Triad.
Like it's driving out of the Triad.
Correct. We're coming into, you're in the end of August now, but pretty soon you're going to be in peak season for all the leaves to be changing.
Oh, yeah.
It's going to get super busy up here.
Bunch of leafers.
Yeah.
Bunch of leafers come through.
Do you say foliage or foliage?
Foliage, I believe.
I'm lazy, so I'm going to say foliage. So, yeah, we're headed up there. End of September, early October is going to kind of be peak for that.
Right.
And you're going to have people coming from all over the place to check that out. But in the winter months, this is also a great spot to come up to. If you are in North Carolina, we can still do snow skiing. You can get up here to Sugar Beach, App.
App has their own mountain, yeah.
And those are all smaller mountains, relatively when you want to compare it to the East Coast. That's enough rambling for now. We're on a road trip. I think one of the things that always comes up is like road trip snacks.
Oh yeah, gotta have the snacks.
Where are you falling on that?
I like a good trail mix. Mountain Dew?
Mountain Dew Extreme! Sunflower seeds, chew and spit.
Starbucks coffee drink.
You gotta make sure that you're prepared for anything.
Mm-hmm.
And generally involves caffeine and sunflower seeds.
That's exactly right.
So higher education anyway.
Yeah, third grade was the longest 3 years of my life.
We're gonna go to Boone. Boone, you got, as you would say here in North Carolina, it's going to be Appalachian State, right? Or just App State.
App State.
If you don't call it Appalachian, you're going to get it looked at a little bit funny. Just call it App State. It's way simpler to call it App State.
Much more simpler.
App State or AS. All right, so we made it up the mountain. We didn't get lost coming up here.
Yep. Ears were popping a little bit.
You're soft. What have I told you? I told you that for a long time. We're just coming down King Street right now. This is kind of Main Street right through Boone. It's where all your shops, restaurants, Mass General Store is going to be.
Great spot.
Good local spot here. You need any of your camping gear, the bulk candy.
Oh, yeah.
You can just go ahead and get as much as you want. Put it on the scale.
Good, like your jellies, jams.
Ooh, they got a raspberry jalapeno that I've had here a bunch of times. Really good.
Okay.
So spice up your morning a little bit with something like that. This is just sort of small mountain town. You know, the campus drives a lot of what's going on around here.
Right.
I actually went to App my first year. A lot of people don't know that before I transferred to Carolina, went to App State. And I was telling Fletcher, you would not have even recognized me. I had hair, weighed like 140 pounds and went running every day.
Yeah, you know, a lot of push-ups every day too.
You're kind of like, that's how life changes on you, right? At one point you're young, making good decisions, and then you end up doing business with Fletcher.
No, but this is a cool spot. I remember just coming here to Boone and Blowing Rock ever since I was a little kid. This is little getaways, especially in college and after college with friends. Come down and get up in the mountains, just kind of get away from it all. It's just such a cool spot, especially this King Street here. That we're walking down with all these shops and restaurants and things to do.
Black Cat right down there. Black Cat burritos. Those things are awesome.
Oh, yeah. Foot Sloggers down there too.
Anything you need, you can get pretty much at Foot Sloggers. Anything for outdoor gear.
Camping, rock climbing, fun things like that. You got a bunch of cool, like, old vintage clothing shops too. Mm-hmm. So if you want to get, like, the mountain mood and dress like a hippie up here,
been down here closer to the convention center on the end of campus. We're gonna spin this around. I always loved this when I would come be here on campus because you got the creek winding right through and everything. Just pretty neat for a college campus to have something like this going right through it. I mean, you know, we started up on King Street and you can see, you know, how close everything really was there to the university. That's the convention center right out there in front of us. So, you know, your basketball games, things like that. The restaurants and that have changed, but the bar that everybody used to go to with either Klondike or Spoons back in the day.
I think Spoons is still here.
Klondike and Spoons. Man, I'm kind of curious to get to the end of this trail and figure that out. We're going to grab a little bit of lunch. We'll check back in with you here shortly.
All right. Well, we are here in Blowing Rock. We took a little lunch break. I just drove about 15 minutes from Boone to Blowing Rock here. It's another just quaint little mountain town. It's almost a getaway from the getaway of Boone. It's a lot smaller, but it's still got a really cool main street here with a lot of shops, some cool restaurants. You got Kilwin's chocolate with fudge, ice cream.
Stopped in there, got a little sample.
We did, a little maple pecan. You got the Spice and Tea Exchange. You got the Speckled Trout, which is a great restaurant. It's just a cool town that's not too far away from Boone. And we, you know, the gazebo that we just walked under on the weekends in the spring, summer, and fall, they have bands that come and play. It's just a neat atmosphere here in Blowing Rock.
Yeah, I mean, there's some really cool homes up here, too. I know I stayed with somebody up here with some buddies a couple of years after college, and we stayed in a house where the actual home was cantilevered over the edge of a cliff, essentially. But for right now, I'm going to turn this off. We're going to go get some fudge.
Oh, yeah.
I don't know about spices, not that adventurous.
Oh, they got great spices, great teas in the Spice and Tea Exchange. Good for grilling, you grill?
I do enjoy grilling.
Yeah.
Do enjoy grilling. All right, we'll talk to you guys in a minute. Yeah, so headed back down the mountain now and gone past Tweetsie Railroad.
Used to be my favorite thing to do as a kid.
I could see you trying to be play conductor.
Also, okay. Gem mining is right next to it, mm-hmm. where you pay a lot of money to dig through sand and get gravel. It's fantastic.
Also, I've been past a couple Christmas tree farms. That's one thing that you'll see, you know, coming into November, and that is getting closer mm-hmm. to Thanksgiving. Everybody's getting ready for the holidays.
Oh, yeah.
Come up here, cut down your own tree.
Oh, yeah. You don't really cut it down. They come and cut it down for you.
I've cut down my own.
I mean, I've cut down my own as well, but they usually have people up there that'll cut it
yes,
down
for you. Yes, you can do it either way.
Yeah. But I've gone up here the last couple of years to get my own Christmas tree. Great experience to come out. Just come. I mean, it's a good excuse just to get to the mountains and just do something fun for the day. Go out, walk the hills, pick out the perfect family Christmas tree. The Griswold family Christmas tree.
Yeah, I would rather go sledding. All right, so we're just wrapping up the day now. We've been to Boone, checked out Blowing Rock. And now you can see we're in the middle of the mountains here. We're just off the Blue Ridge Parkway. Mm-hmm. This is why you move up here. And if you're ever interested in this, again, super easy trip from Winston. But if you want to purchase a home up here, mm-hmm. Berkshire's got offices up here too. We have agents that we can partner with. So if you're looking for anything like that, let us know. We'd be happy to make an introduction. I'm Joel with Berkshire.
I'm Fletcher Bingham with Berkshire.
Thanks for watching another weekend road trip edition of Driving Triad. Best number to get us, 336-582-9210 or joel@sandmanrealtync.com. And Fletcher is?
336-689-5677, Fletcher@sandmanrealtync.com.
Take it easy.
See y'all.